Welcome to a lesson on geometric formulas. The goal of this video is to determine the perimeter and area of various geometric shapes. What we'll do is we'll cover the basic formulas, and at the very end we'll take a look at justifying some of these. A polygon is a closed geometric figure with three or more sides. The perimeter of any polygon is the distance around it, or the sum of the lengths of its sides. So really, when it comes to a perimeter, you don't have to memorize any formula. Find the perimeter of a polygon, you can just find the sum of the lengths of all sides. However, we will talk about a couple more common formulas. The perimeter of a square is 4 times the length of a side. So for example, if I call this side length S, that means all of them would have to be length S. If we find the sum of these four sides, it would be equal to 4s. So if we knew the length of one of the sides was equal to 5 inches, they would all be equal to 5 inches, and the perimeter would equal 4 times 5 inches, which would give us 20 inches. Similarly, the perimeter of a rectangle is twice the sum of the length and the width, or 2 times the length plus 2 times the width. So if this side is length L, then this one would also be length L. And if this one is length W, this one would also be length W. Notice we have two L's and two W's, hence the perimeter formula. So now if we know that this length is equal to 4 feet, and this width is equal to 8 feet, we could use the perimeter formula to find their perimeter. It would be 2 times 4 feet plus 2 times 8 feet, which would equal 8 feet plus 16 feet, which would give us a perimeter of 24 feet. So if we find the sum of the lengths of all four sides, we would get 24 feet. Now let's talk about a circle. The perimeter of a circle is called the circumference, and the circumference is equal to pi times the diameter, or 2 times pi times the radius. The diameter goes from one side of the circle to the other, passing through the center, while the radius is a segment from the center to the edge of the circle. So depending on what you're given will affect which formula that you'll use. However, if you look at this sketch, if you multiply the radius times 2, it would equal the diameter, or you can say that the radius is half the diameter. So as an example, if we were given that the diameter is equal to 20 meters, we would use the first formula, and that would be pi, which is approximately 3.14 times 20 meters, which would equal 62.8 meters. Now this is approximately equal to pi, so this is an approximation of the true circumference. Okay, let's go ahead and talk about area now. The area of a square is the square of the length of a side. So again, we know all of these sides have the same length. If we're given that this length is equal to 4 centimeters, then the area will equal 4 centimeters times 4 centimeters, which will equal 16 centimeters squared. Notice the units for area are square units. And where that comes from is if we were to take this square and divide it into square centimeters, there would be 16 of them inside the square. And this is very similar to a rectangle. If I have a rectangle that is 5 millimeters by 8 millimeters, the area will be equal to the length times the width, or 5 millimeters times 8 millimeters, which would give us 40 millimeters squared. Now let's talk about the area of a parallelogram. The area is the product of the length of the base and the height, or the base times the height. So this is the base. So if this base is equal to 12 meters and the height is equal to 6 meters, then the area is equal to 6 meters times 12 meters, which equals 72 meters squared, which is just like the area of a rectangle, because if you take this triangle and you put it over here, you would have a rectangle. But we'll take a look at that in more detail at the end. And next, we have the area of a triangle. The area is half the length of the base times the height, or base times height divided by 2. Remember, dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1/2. So again, here's our base. Let's call this 20 feet, and our height let's say, is 8 feet, then the area is equal to, I'll use the second formula, base times the height divided by 2, which equals 80 square feet. Let's move along to what's probably the most involved area formula. It is the area of a trapezoid. The area is equal to half the product of the height and the sum of the lengths of the parallel sides, or the product of the height and the average length of the bases. This would be base 1, this would be base 2, and of course this is the height. So as an example, if this is 14 inches, and this is 10 inches, and our height is equal to 6 inches, let's go ahead and use this first formula this time. The area is equal to 1/2 times the height of 6 inches times the sum of base 1 plus base 2, or 14 inches plus 10 inches. Now notice how I'm leaving the units in the formulas. A lot of times textbooks don't do that, but I like leaving them in because it really reminds you that area is in square units and the perimeter is not. So here we have 1/2 times 6 inches, that would be 3 inches. 14 inches plus 10 inches equals 24 inches. And you can see we have 3 times 24, that would be 72, and inches times inches is equal to inches squared. The last formula we'll look at is the area of a circle. Notice the area formulas for a circle involve the radius. So if you have the diameter, you do have to divide by 2 to find the radius for this formula. So area equals pi times radius times radius. But of course, this can be written as r squared. So if we're asked to find the area of this circle, the first thing that they recognize is we need the radius. This is the diameter, so the radius would be half of that, or 5 feet. So the area is going to equal pi times 5 feet squared, which would give us 25 pi feet squared. Remember, pi is a constant. But normally we do want to get a decimal approximation of this. If we multiply 25 times 3.14, we get 78.5 square feet. Notice it's an approximation. Okay, let's go ahead and take a moment and see where these formulas actually come from. I would highly encourage you to visit this website and do some of your own exploring. You have the website, and these were made by Bettina and Tom Richmond. Let's go ahead and take a look at this triangle animation. So what happens here is you double the triangle, and then you slide it to form a parallelogram. And we know that the area of a parallelogram is base times height. So if we take the area of this parallelogram and then divide by 2, you would have the area of the triangle that we're looking for. Let's go ahead and take a look at the parallelogram also. So what we do is we draw an altitude, creating a triangle, and then we move this triangle over to the right side, and you can see now it has the same area as a rectangle, and the area would be base times height, the same as a rectangle, even though we used length times width. Let's also take a look at the trapezoid. So we have a single trapezoid, make a copy of it, slide them together, and you can see that we have a parallelogram where one side of the parallelogram is the base 1 plus base 2 times the height, but again it's double the area that we want, so of course we have to divide by 2, which gives us one of those formulas for the area of a trapezoid. Let's go and take a look at the area of a circle. Divide it up into little pies, cut them apart, slide them together. This would be the length of the radius. This is half the circumference, or pi times r. So the area would be pi times r, which is equal to pi r squared. So again, I'd encourage you to take a look at this website. It's got some neat animations, and spend some more time with it. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.